A big concern about Ball State taking over Muncie Community Schools is that they will not have to follow the state's bullying law. Call 6 Investigates Kara Kenny has been tracking bullying in our schools and continues our team coverage on this development. Kara.
That's right, Erica. The bullying law was signed by the governor back in 2013, and it requires schools have a bullying prevention policy and do training. But child advocates say under this new plan for Muncie, Muncie won't have to do any of that. The bullying law requires schools to report bullying incidents to the Indiana Department of Education. The agency and child advocates can then use that information to track when and where bullying is happening. A Call 6 investigation also prompted new bullying legislation that will also allow the state to audit schools to make sure they're telling the true picture about bullying. But Muncie won't have to follow any of this if the governor signs House Bill 1315. It's not yet clear why the bullying requirement was left out of this legislation, but we have calls into a number of state lawmakers to find out. The Indiana Coalition for Public Education says they want to know as well, and they call the move unconscionable. ICP is scratching our heads, collective heads, as to why Ball State will be allowed to ignore so many laws that all other public schools, including charter schools, must follow, particularly as they relate to protecting students. Now, it's not just the bullying law Muncie won't have to follow. They also will not have to follow the seclusion and restraint reporting requirement, as well as the law that says schools have to disclose the details of superintendent contracts. Erica.